Whew. That was a bit of a freaking crazy morning. So far, Zafaro's welcome to my second stream in November 4, 2024. We are nearing the end of the year. It's just gonna get crazier from here. Oh man. Oh. Crazy, crazy, crazy. Anywho, let's keep things simple and keep things rolling with Fallout 4. I know I didn't change anything. I got up at 7 something and during my morning throne sitting. I kind of got caught up watching a couple of things. So, yeah. Like a history of Fallout 4 video. I know it's like a decade or two past, or a decade past when the game was released, not quite 2 decades. What am I talking about? But, the lore of Fallout 4 is absolutely fascinating to me. Absolutely love it. Absolutely love it to pieces. And the detail that's popping up within the Fallout universe. I'm tempted to write my. I've been tempted for a while to write a story of my own vein, mostly regarding. Actually, it started earlier. Sort of like my own sort of Fallout-ish story. With like vague references to. Now with vague references to Fallout, things like that. I'm calling it original fiction because I'm not working on it in the sense of, oh yeah. It's a different preview. Preview pane, there we go. Sky, yeah, okay. Aging glass from Fallout Canada. Oh yeah, this was a sort of start to it. I had a different one before. Where did I put it? It's a beautiful desolation. It's part of it. States. There's a few interesting ideas. I don't think I kept that actually. I might have deleted it. It's kind of disappointing. I thought that it would be there. Anyways, yeah, I started working back on a Fallout project. Actually, let's go back here. Let's go back here and see. Take a look at Fallout Canada. Put it in this. No. Okay. No. Signature. Oh yeah, I gotta download Mechanist here. Oh, right. Back here. Writing stories. Pokemon, ponies. Used to do a lot of different stories. Started working on a murder drone story called Chapter R. About my take on a character named Serial Designation R. I have a picture of it actually on my phone. I haven't uploaded. What's it? Did I even keep the map I was working on for Fallout Canada, or I had a map for Fallout, which I was going to center around Surrey. I do not believe I kept it. Oh, right, here we go. Fallout Central City. Fallout Central City taking place in centered around Central City in Surrey. Location and let's walk through this. Let's do first. Go back. Go mainstreaming here. Okay, Fallout Central City is a Fallout that I have it all in my head, but I haven't written it down, so I might have forgotten a few things. During my idea of Fallout, as they had the story centers around Central City in Surrey. And basically the Central City Mall, actually, is where it takes place. It's roughly about that area, or somewhere over here, I'm not entirely sure. No, about there. And that is, like, they have this Central City Mall there that they had as part of the construction in this universe, they had installed a rather gigantic Fallout shelter there. I'm not planning on using Vault tech specifically for this, because I'm planning on, because I've given Canada its own version of Vault tech called Leaf tech, actually. And the whole thing is, each of the leaves are, or each of the, I'm just going to use vaults because it's easy. It's been a while since I've looked at this. You have the strikes. You've got a Raider City in North Vancouver. The Great Vancouver Crater, which is this entire area here, except for in Stanley Park, which is effectively an island. You have UBC, which was taken over, made into an Air Force base. In fact, actually, this was the hardest part. Despite this being one of the main areas for takeover by the U.S. in the Fallout universe, they actually had a heck of a time keeping this under control. I mean, of course, Edmonton was the one that was the tipping point, but this was one of the first areas secured. Not necessarily Vancouver proper, although they did secure the port down in the major port in Vancouver, in English Bay. And that was the way to get everything around the province, around the area to where they needed to. Most of the road traffic didn't actually come through Surrey. They decided to calculate the shortest distance and ended up going through most of the border crossings at, like, east of this, like Abbotsford, simply because it was less time consuming to go through there and having to deal with all the traffic in this area. Not that it matters much to the end, but when this area was finally subdued and taken over, Central City became a sort of central hub, if you will. Then when Edmonton was conquered in the Fallout universe, there was a rise of a certain hashtag. That hashtag being, unlike in the modern era where they're common, the hashtag TNSF or True North Strong and Free took over Canadian messages, and it wasn't necessarily identified directly by a hashtag either. It was or pound sign or whatever. It was more like scattered throughout it. Like if you saw in sequence, a lot of people used it as a sort of cipher. In a way, to get the everything together, Central City was the birthplace of the Vancouver chapter of the Canadian Preservation Front, which started in Edmonton. In fact, it was passed through a number of areas before Vancouver in the east out towards Hope was cut off by a massive resurgence towards Hope around the I haven't come up with that yet, but somewhere between Chilliwack and Hope, there's a massive overgrowth of blackberries. Also, in this universe, when you hit the U.S. border, kind of around here-ish, but lower. They set up a blockade there. Actually, the blockade's somewhere along the Elgin Channel here. Elgin Chanterelle, whatever this is called here. And you end up there's a patrol here of and a completely oversized Deathclaw patrols this area. It's virtually immune to bullet fire and all that stuff. Crescent Beach, the main settlements of this area, the Delta Fortress, which is taken up on Barber Island, Mitchell Island, Raider City, which is also a dungeon, if you will, Deep Cove, New Vancouver, Central City, Maple Ridge, Fraser Downs, Crescent Beach. And there's no connection down here directly. There's some other settlements, some smaller ones. Fraser Crescent, Grade 7. The Grade 7 is a collection of raider groups that have kind of settled down, not doing so much raider stuff because they found more profit in the trade and protecting people along this road here, connecting Crescent Beach and Delta Fortress and passing by Burns Fog. Both the Burns Bog area in Delta, which usually ends up being the source of fire in modern times, ends up turning into an eternally burning, like low level burning area, but like with like radiation, because there was a nuclear strike that hit there. Central City diverted a strike to Mayhem City, which is north of Newton kind of area. Fisher Downs is where the racetrack, the racetrack and all the whatever it is, I forget. Then there's a bunch of, there are actually a couple of vaults, three vaults in here, and the rest are created by Leaf Tech. There's the Bay Vault, Vault 911, Vault 911, Vault 15, and Vault 15. Those are all, the only ones that are actually Vault Tech are Vault 911 and Vault 15. The Bay Vault was one that was just started when the world ended. Tawasin, Newton Wildlands, Barnston Depths, Pit River Hideout, Pacific Ruins, those are all, and Ambush Acres are all non-Vault Tech. They were all created by Leaf Tech. Bay Vault actually, Bay Vault is one that was created by one of Vancouver's wealthiest individuals for personal use, but ended up being absolutely overrun when Vancouver was attacked. Anyways, yeah, this is kind of where what I'm, kind of a rough start to Fallout Central City, Fallout Vancouver kind of idea. I do have some plans for further out. Like it's of course not going to be. It's going to be treated sort of like Boston in a way, in Fallout 4, where this area is going to be given the greatest amount of detail, and then these are all going to be like. Except yeah, Vancouver and Surrey are going to be the main ones. I know Burnaby, and the rest are larger towns, but they're. Vancouver and Surrey. Surrey's going to be given the main focus. Vancouver and Surrey are going to be given the main focus. These are the two most populous spots in the region. Surrey actually will, by the time the bombs fell in 2077 or whatever, Surrey will have overtaken Vancouver in terms of population size, as it will have today, in about 10 years. There's going to be some kind of division happening here. A few other things are going to happen. This is not complete. This is basically a rough idea of what I'm thinking for my Fallout Boy Vancouver universe. I don't know exactly what the difference is here. Then there's Pokemon Legacy, Shadows of Destruction, something different. Anyways, that's enough about my fanfiction. Let's get to playing. I've got so many different writing thoughts and ideas that I'll get to eventually. I've written in years, though. It's not to that extent. At least a year or two. Also because of health scares and things like that. I necessarily want to... Oops. What did I just do? Oh, that's what. Okay. Alright. Let's head over from Vancouver to Boston.
Let's head over to Boston. You see exactly
what is up. Oh, man. Okay. DJ Atomic. I have to check out my other file later. Because I've got squashes we were running through. Kitty Kingdom. The other day, I was trying to make it through sort of a pacifist style thing. But, it didn't work out too well. That's all those ghouls crashed my computer. Crashed the game at least. Okay. Where was I going? Mechanist Lair, okay. Oops. Done. Well, boom. Ooh, nasty. Nasty. Victorian sucker. You're not much better than Raiders, so other than being more organized. Go find that. Walking through the burning wreckage. Okay. Right. Is there any way to make them hostile by annihilating people who are... Do they send out any way at all? Oh, jeez. What, the legendary Rad Scorpion? Well, that's interesting. Is this just turned into a raider camp anyway? Still flooded. It's still flooded. But not as flooded as... No, wait, yeah, it is. It's as flooded as it was. I wonder. Can I? No human could possibly dive this deep IRL. Oh, there's nothing down here. Well, they probably could, but you know. Looked and am now up. I can still complete this without the guy. I just don't know if I want to give this up to the raiders or not. It's officially what it would be. You can still do it. That's a power box. So I can still do it. Leave the spot open to raiders. Nice try. I didn't do anything, okay. Does this go down casually, or does it just... Where would that water go anyway? Does it just go into the, sewer system, or...? Just kind of flooded out at the moment. I thought that was just a green texture. Oh well. That was weird. Alright, well, you know, let's clear that out. Ada. Settlement recruitment beacon signal found. You're kind of happy. Rad storms. You're a rad storm. Nope, it's all busted. Alright. Oh, hi. Oh, yeah, hey. One by one. Foolish turn to field goal. Immediately I execute him, of course. I didn't do anything. Okay. other than some coins, no. Okay. Hey, Sparky. Was that a couple of laser shots from this area? Very possibly. Yeah, it looks like it. Okay. Instead of doing that, still got the mysterious signal tagged up. Transfer to Robco. It's never approved by General Atomics or National Robco. Destruction of wide range robots. How about just wide robots? Really, really wide ones. 14 kilometers wide. Oh my gosh, it'd be a massive wide robot. I can't imagine that getting through any doors. Or even cities. This handbook for one of my drone from my model helicopters here says use your hand duke. It's a quick look. Use your hand duke. Funny. Alright, let's go. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Dude. Load you. Well, I can't exactly load it, but you know. And 3-2-1 crashes. And 3-2-1 crashes. And 3-2-1 crashes. No, no. Load up. Ooh. Oh. on. Come on, Robco. Okay, that didn't help any. Oh, there we go. Better.
Sweet.
What happened? Did my screen just get wider? Looks like my screen just got wider. Feels like it. Yeah, it's off proportion. Yeah, it's way off proportion, okay. I'm gonna have to restart this. Restart this, because this is gonna get all funky at some point. Yeah. Proportions aren't taking. Switch up. More specifically, switch back. Before things get too nuts. That's better. Restart. New Coca-Cola. All the world's worst flavors in one bottle. Anyways. Something like that. Something like this ripper here. Wouldn't that ultimately not be powered by gasoline? Because gasoline would be too expensive. Although in the this area would be cheaper than, I don't know. It's kind of odd. For an area so intent on running with nuclear power. But again, though, I guess at this point it would be less expensive to run off gas than by nuclear. That feels better. I don't have to worry about anything until later. Superthaw antifreeze. RX-6550 terminal crashes immediately on boot up. Suspect overheating. Entire console needs cleaning. We'll reevaluate once all hardware is liberated. Terminal unit systems have been stopped. Please verify that all necessary hardware and software is properly installed. If problems continue, contact your nearest Rocco Sales Service Center for immediate assistance. I would find that a little bit annoying, having to look at that while servicing the machine. Then that's what I'm here for, dummy. But you know, that's like
over here.
That's kind of the purpose, though. Point. Not a lot is getting through that.
There we go.
Security officer, Epsilon 6 security alert has been declared. All systems have been locked down. Your security station, wait for instructions. Wait, security protocol. Last 5 counter espionage procedure, Gamma 9 security alert, Epsilon 6 security alert, and Omega protocol. In the event of a confirmed nuclear detonations, the facility administrator, or in his absence, the highest level supervisor on duty, hereafter acting administrator, incident a temporary lockdown and order all staff to shelter in place. A loss of contact with the military chain of command is to be expected. After a period of no less than 12 hours from the LOC event, and the acting administrator shall attempt to reestablish contact. The Emergency Communications Protocol Appendix 9. Any instructions transmitted pursuant to those communications are blah 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 blah. I missed that. Pursuant to those communications are to be followed and supersede this protocol. In the event that communications cannot be yourselves within 24 hours from lockdown from LOC, the acting administrator shall initiate an orderly shutdown of the facility. Test subjects are to be secured in their cells. Facility staff remaining on site are to delete any sensitive files and records, close down their stations, arm themselves, and collect their personal belongings. If communications have not been reestablished by 30 hours from LOC, the acting administrator shall activate lockdown mode Omega. This will provide a 10-minute window for staff to evacuate the facility. This evacuation should be presumed to be permanent. Once initiated, the lockdown can only be terminated via remote authorization from the Military Robotics Oversight Committee. Can't quite imagine what that would be. Oh. I have locked myself out. Oops. Everything but old flask. Oh, I didn't need the pistol. Well, unlock expert. Whee, bobby pin. Well, those gates are useless now.
The scourge of the Commonwealth has used my own technology against me. You may have gained access to my sanctum, but you'll need better skills than that to defeat me.
Get him. Use this.
There's three things that I can go grab. The research. Okay, we used to go to the research wing. I guess it doesn't matter anymore. Wild doors attack. Seeing everything.
Yes.
Epsilon, yep. Lieutenant Justin Green, U.S. Army. Now transferred over to run protection control today. The idiot from General Atomics got pulled after he let the department efficiency drop below 90%. Private sector buffoons have it so easy. Imagine being content with such a crappy rating and not even having to account for the shortfall. I'm going to start getting things back on track down here and show the civilians and the U.S. military wants to show. Took well, but I finally weeded out the last of those General Atomics ingrates from my department. Who the heck did they think they were, anyway? I've never seen a lazy bunch of good-for-nothing layabouts in my life. Lost paperwork, mislaid supplies, inferior assembly work, you name it, and these clowns with a cause. Then there's Sarah Wolachek. She was supposed to be GA's pride and joy down here. I caught her hooking up with the Robo Brain heads to one of our recompilers and trying to have a conversation with it, asking was it sad and could it feel in pain. Are you kidding me? I fired her on the spot. How a private company gets anything done with the discipline, I'll never know. That jerk. What the folder? Okay.
Yes.
Search and protect on control, choose personality mode. Done.
Hold.
Yes.
Let's go.
You see? Shot claw. Let's switch you up to assault run legs. There we are.
engineer, Thomas Harkin. So far, we're tracking on schedule for the latest RoboBrain milestone. Dr. Asante has assured me that the active time between memory wipes has been greatly increased. Hopefully, that will hold true in our latest live testing. The senior engineers also informed me that their latest assembly line adjustments have been completed early. I can only hope that means due diligence was still paid, and we're not going to be looking at a total system breakdown again. Other than that, I'm still worried about the test subjects. Right now, we've got more than enough to meet our demand. But it's not like these things grow on trees.
Tank.
May as well take what we can. They won't be needing those items any longer.
Unload in his face, all of it. Done. Thank you. That is definitely a thing.
Scan this.
Probably shouldn't.
Use this. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. Substation A. Babysitting a reactor.
The sealed gate thing. Actually, this is a pretty impressive base that you could do a whole lot with here. I'm not surprised the Mechanist took this one up. Junk bots, first aid.
Got it.
It's darker than I remember it down here. Facilities management terminal. Alrighty. Zip zap. I didn't need to stay on the leveler.
Open this.
So many doors.
Thank you. That's it.
Now, there would be entire sections of the Commonwealth that would be completely and totally undisturbed. That includes no smashed computers. Even 200 years later. Might be a little bit dustier. There's no... here. I suck to you. Move thy butt, Ada. The ones that kept. Ones that were kept. Observation.
Please notify security and enhance lockdown protocol.
Why should I? It's no fun to do it that way. Absolutely no fun to do it that way. find some of these other ones. Whatever happened there wasn't good. Terminals. That's quite a stall. That is quite a tall stack of filing cabinets.
Security. As thorough as our assembly procedures may be, there's a human factor to be considered. These are criminal and unstable minds. It can't be a scientist's job to ensure each test subject is properly sedated. I was promised military assistance and security, but we need more. I won't allow my crew to be endangered. As fascinating as it may be to integrate the human mind with robotics, sometimes I wish I never signed on to this project.
Yeah, I would say so too.
Find anything useful?
Yeah. I found two of them. Sorry, miscellany.
Anise Ciroletti, Chief Scientist. This is the third time I've had to request more security. As thorough as our assembly procedures may be, there's a human factor to be considered. These are criminal and unstable minds. It can't be a scientist's job to ensure each test subject is properly set.
Lead engineer, Thomas Harkin. So far, we're tracking on schedule for the latest RoboBrain milestone. Dr. Asante has assured me that the active time between memory wipes has been greatly increased. Hopefully, that will hold true in our latest live testing. The senior engineers also informed me that their latest assembly line adjustments have been completed early. I can only hope that means due diligence was still paid, and we're not going to be looking at a total system breakdown again. Other than that, I'm still worried about the test subjects. Right now, we've got more than enough to meet our demand. But it's not like these things grow on trees.
Where is the last one? One more. Forget where it is. Something on here. Medical terminal password. Is pretty far away.
Scan this.
It's a bit longer than this. I doubt it is. But yeah, no. Before this. Tape anywhere I'm kicking around. I'm going to go the other way. There's apparently another way to go. Let me see here. I don't have the facilities engine to facilities directors. Facilities management terminal. Where is it? Connection error. Streamlabs is open, dang it. Seriously? Anyway. Facilities director. The turbo reconditioning. Director. Where is the facilities director? Director thing.
Anyway, I got McDaniel up there taking a look. But if that fan needs replacing again, I'm having Fadley fired. I don't care if he is some hotshots kid. He can't do this job. And I'm the one that's got to answer to Rawlings.
Yeah, it's 6 to be him. Let's go back. Running, 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 all the way back to the top. You can't do the job, you shouldn't be here, basically. This is a long walk. Up yet.
Got it.
Anise Ciroletti, Chief Scientist. This is the third time I've had to request more security.
Engineer, Thomas Harkin.
For a manual override.
Going down.
Yes, we are going down.
You underestimated me.
A regretful miscalculation. You bypassed the pinnacle of pre-war security systems. I can see you're no common criminal. Perhaps we can reason this out. Let us discuss this amicably.
Who are you? Don't you think it's time you ditched that mask?
All right.
I'm Isabel Cruz. The Mechanist was just an easy way for me to help the Commonwealth. But all my technical knowledge and all of these resources, and I still failed. How does the Commonwealth have any hope against people like you?
Hey, I'm not the enemy. I'm the one trying to protect the Commonwealth against your robots.
They have taken innocent lives. My friends, they were simple traitors, all dead at the hands of your robots.
Yep.
That can't be right. Explain yourself.
They're misinterpreting orders. Your own RoboBrain said as much. They're saving people by killing them.
Saving by killing? No. It's... the logic, it's there. I can see it now. I was hoping it was the RoboBrains, an issue with their memory wipes. You are right.
Primary directive was flawed.
Primary directive was flawed.
robo brains require memory wipes?
Yes. The human brain has a way of rewiring itself. If not properly maintained, it can corrupt.
That sounds like a serious flaw, and a dangerous one at that.
It is, but the process is thorough. They're wiped after each mission. I found it's best not to let them recall what they've been through.
Now you know the truth. Your robots are dangerous. They had
must
to be stopped.
Be
the hero unknowingly became the villain. I wanted to help the Commonwealth. And robots are all I know. I found this place and figured I could finally do my part. I accept full responsibility. I can't take back what I've done, or even atone for it. But this doesn't have to end in violence.
Your plan backfired. If you're telling the truth, this was one costly accident.
It is the truth. I only ever wanted to make the Commonwealth a safer place. I grew up on a settlement. I've seen how good people struggle against raiders and super mutants. I'd never want to be counted among them. Here, take this. It's the password to the mainframe. You can use it to shut down the security protocols. I'd rather this place be in your hands now.
Hey there.
Thank you for understanding.
Control password. Hostile targets. Turn hostile targets. Please wait. It's getting frosted targets. It's just some faultable defaults. Increasing repairs.
To say I'm really happy, thankful that you've let me stick around here, and in order to show you that I'm done with the past, I want you to have this
sort of promise. I guess
it's the Mechanist suit I made.
You don't have to do that.
I want to. I need to move on, and this just seemed the right way to handle it. There's one more thing. A much bigger thing. There are still robots out there. Lots of them. My communications are down, and I can't call them back. But I can tell you where they are, if you're interested.
Sure.
Great. Let's see here. Yes, there's another one out there. Hope it's not too much trouble.
Robots. Anyways, that is all I'm going to do for now. I will do something else later. But I do have the party like it's 1940. I mean, no. Yeah, that's part of the link. Information terminal. This terminal may only be accessed with an R30 alpha clearance. By accessing the terminal, the viewer acknowledges that the appropriate clearance is held. Violations are punishable and subject to military jurisdiction. To mark the first official meeting of the minds within the new facility, General Rawlings met with representatives of General Atomics, Anna Karim, and Gregory Adler. I firmly believe that having the U.S. military working side by side with these brilliant scientists will yield some amazing results. And the government to work with private industry is going to be a challenge. The project will either prove to be ingenious or a completely wasted effort. I think we're already seeing promise. The personal need to be one up each other may be the best motivation yet. And a bunch of other stuff. Anywho. Continue onward. Next time. Thank you for watching. If you like what you do, like, subscribe, follow, whatever your platform allows. If you want to support me further, I have my link tree up that way. I'm working on developing my own website. Sort of-ish. Yeah. And, yeah. Hopefully we'll see you on Friday. Hopefully we'll have more time. Yeah, we're already in. Yeah, Wednesday. Anyways, thank you very much. Have an excellent day. And yeah, we'll see you on Wednesday. Cheers. Peace.